Getting ready to go to work this morning. Got a text from Tisha Fierce asking if I can pick her up some donuts. I just want to make it clear and state on the record that I do not eat donuts. I didn't want the donuts. Tisha wanted donuts. So I'm gonna get her some donuts. So the myth about cops and donuts is not true. All right, Tisha. I got your donuts. Happy vlog day, everybody. Today I have my patrol uniform on. That can only mean one thing. We're going on patrol. Again. Last vlog, I was tied up with that accident for a majority of the shift. So I decided, let's give it another go. We're gonna be going into the Central District area today. And we're gonna be riding around with Sergeant Diaz. Right now, I just got to the station. I'm gonna go give Tisha Fierce her donuts that she requested. Headed into the station. I think it's gonna rain today. I don't know. I'm not a weatherman, but I have a hunch.
Hey, Officer Byers.
What's going on, pounding?
Good morning, sir. Good morning. Okay. It is vlog day Miami.
All right.
Have a great day.
That's it?
That's it. Have a great day.
You're back from vacation, man. We missed you on the vlog.
Listen, vacation.
It's been like four vlogs vacation, since you've been on there.
Don't even go there. You were on vacation too. Have a good day. Take care, guys.
All right. Tisha's not here, so I'm just gonna put it on the desk, wait for her to come. I'm gonna put the camera inside the donut bag, and we're gonna do donut cam. You'll get to see first person what it's like to be one of Tisha's donuts. All right, putting it in the bag, and when she comes, I'll sneak over here and turn it on. Donut cam. Oh, she's here, donut cam.
Donuts
today. You're so strange. What are you doing?
Nothing, just donuts in there. I got you some good donuts.
Donut cam! Oh my god. My hair is
donut cam!
It's so silly.
What are you going for, Miss Tisha Fierce?
Donuts. I love donuts. I'm so happy. I was waiting for these.
You see, it wasn't me, guys. I told you. Getting ready to go out of the office, and we got some mail delivered. So, want to take a second real quick, open up the mail, and check it out. All right, this package is from all the way from Verona, New Jersey. Let's take a look, see what we got right here. Oh, yes. Favorite part. And the note reads, hey gang, I wanted to say thank you for all the hard work you guys do in humanizing the badge. I'm a detective in the city of Newark, New Jersey Police Department and find it so hard to see positive police interactions. However, your unit shows that we are all really good people. Thanks again and keep up the good work. Also, please do not read.
No!
Okay. Also, please do not air my name in any of the vlogs. I'd appreciate it. Thank you. I wish it said on the package not to say my name. So I'm just gonna bleep that. Awesome. We got a Newark police patch added to the collection. The Newark Police Department shirt has a patch again right here on the chest. Thank you so much for the shirt. I will be wearing it. And thank you again. And you guys stay safe over in Newark. Okay, let's go meet up with Sergeant Diaz. She's waiting for us outside. All right, so this is the central roll call room. This is where the officers sit. And when it's roll call time, Sergeant will stand up here and give them their orders for the day. So the central office, and this is the central sergeant's office, the admin office. This is where all the sergeant's desks are at. And let's see if sergeant's in there. Oh, we have two sergeants in here.
What up, Nikki?
What's going on? Wanna say what's up?
How you doing?
What's up, all right. Sarge!
How are you, Nick?
What's up? Oh, nice handshake. Good firm handshake there. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready. Quick question. What are your duties here so we can inform our 15s on the vlog?
Well, early sergeant, which is the sergeant that comes before the shift, usually comes in an hour before, and what we do is a roster. So we account for all the troops that we have out there, and each individual zone has to have a certain amount of staffing, which is a certain amount of people per area.
Okay, so that's what you're doing now?
I am, and I just finished, so I gotta print it out.
Okay, and then you take care of any paperwork, and then?
And that's pretty much it, then I go back up my units.
All right, so is that what we're gonna do right now?
We're gonna go do that.
Let's do it. We're gonna go back up some units. What area are we working today, Sarge?
Allapattah.
AP.
AP.
Yeah, yeah, it's the area where I started.
This is my horse.
That's your horse. What do you call her?
Kitty.
Kitty. See, she has a name. She has a name for her car. So,
what's the odds?
It came out from underneath?
Yeah. Kitty.
Now I know why you call it Kitty.
Yep.
Sarge.
Yes.
Can you tell me the difference between a sergeant's car and a patrol officer's car?
Sure, look back. No cage.
Okay, so sergeants don't have cages.
Correct.
In the back of their police cars. Because a lot of guys ask about the inside of the police cars and they want to know why some have cages and why some don't. Supervisors.
Correct, sergeants and above.
Don't have cages.
No cage.
Alright, so what's going on? An officer has the subject running from him not too far away. He called for an emergency backup. We are en route now over there to go assist that officer. All right, so you got an officer car. This looks like the officer that was either assisting, either the officer that was assisting or the primary officer. So we're gonna make sure that his doors are closed. The subject is in custody. All right, so his doors are closed. We're good. Those are the officers that had the guys ran from that overtime PST. By the way, Sergeant Guzman used to be on overtime PST.
I retired. I hung it up.
He used to be on overtime PST. Sergeant, what happened?
We responded in emergency mode to overtime.
I saw that.
And we had an officer who requested a backup. Mm-hmm. He had a subject that was running from him.
Okay.
Through the projects, and he was apprehended.
Okay, cool. So that was PST?
Correct.
So they normally patrol this area?
Overtime, I believe you did a vlog on it.
I did do a vlog on it.
I pay attention, you see?
Sarge watches the vlogs.
I do.
Sarge watches the vlogs.
Subscriber.
So, Sergeant, is this your area?
No, this is Overtime, but I did work here for probably 6 to 7 years.
Really? How long have you been on?
It's gonna be 10 years soon.
Woo! I think we came on around the same time.
Correct. You're in the class before me.
Okay.
Relax. It's only a month.
I wasn't gonna say anything.
It's only a month.
So Sarge, did you know this is the first on the vlog?
The first what?
The first time we're in Allapattah.
Nice. Welcome to Allapattah.
Yep. Can you tell us a little bit about Allapattah?
Well, Allapattah is one of the biggest areas. Our borders west is basically like three different jurisdictions. It goes from County, Miami Springs, and Hialeah. Then north, we have Model City. South of us is Little Havana, and to our east is Wynwood.
Wynwood.
Yes.
We discussed Wynwood on the last vlog. You wanna know what we talked about?
What did you talk about?
Do you watch the vlogs?
I do watch the vlogs.
So you should know.
I'm testing you. Wasn't it Zika?
It was Zika, you're right. And since you are border Wynwood area, do you take any precautions?
Yes.
With Zika? Oh, as simple as that.
Correct.
So CDC came out and discussed a little bit about Zika. What did they tell you?
Yes, they came to our roll call. We had a PowerPoint presentation and they explained Zika and what four symptoms to look for to see if you have it, and it's just a minimum of two. Either it's like a rash, mm-hmm. something like chickenpox.
Okay.
Red eyes like pink eye, fever. The last is joint pain. So if you have two of the four symptoms, then you should go to your primary care physician or an emergency room.
Okay. And you're good so far?
I'm good. I just had my physical. I'm good.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Yes.
And that physical, is that on your own?
No, actually the city pays for annual physicals for the department.
Mm-hmm.
And you go to basically Mount Sinai and get the main tests are given to you there.
Okay, so the city's looking after us.
Correct.
All right. No Zika.
No Zika.
She's Zika free.
Zika free.
All right. All right, while we're at the gas pumps, Sarge's filling up.
I think I'm gonna don my vest because we haven't been out here but 15 minutes and we're already, it's already moving and grooving.
So Sarge, you work Allapattah.
Yes.
But right when we got out, we went to Overtown.
Correct.
Is Allapattah like close to Overtown?
Yes, they're neighboring zones.
So you go back and forth to the zones when you need, when officers need help or anything like that?
Yeah, and so do my officers. I encourage them whenever, it doesn't matter what zone you're from, if an officer is requesting assistance, they can leave their zone and respond to them. Once everything is cleared and stuff like that, then they can respond back to our zone.
Awesome, okay, cool. Let's keep it going. I'm gonna don the vest.
Me and Sarge, we're gonna get proactive. So we're gonna throw on our vest, do some proactive work out here, and see what's going on.
That's gonna be him.
Okay, have the units hold what they have. Have them get out of their vehicles and have canine respond, please.
Scratch it off.
I got him running and he's going.
Go, Richie.
Northbound.
Between the houses on 21 Avenue. It's a twig, it's a twig.
No, this is two bailouts that we had, and I'm trying to get the VIN numbers for you.
All right, so what's going on is that we saw these two motor scooters driving without their headlights on. We saw them turn the block, so we came down two blocks north from where they were at, and they happened to be turning towards us. And when they saw us coming down the street, they made a U-turn, started heading back the other way, and then when we came up to take a traffic stop, they dumped the bikes and took off running. So all indications lead to say that these scooters, motor scooters, are stolen. We're checking the VINs right now, and what happens is they scratched off the VIN. Usually when the motor scooters are stolen, they'll scratch off the VINs, the ignitions pop, but there are multiple VINs on the motor scooter, so right now we're looking for the other VIN so we can confirm that it's a stolen vehicle. We have perimeter set in the area, and as of now, we believe there's one guy within the perimeter, and we have one guy right now detained. Got Overtown PST helping us out. Appreciate it. We'll be right back.
Sarge.
Yes.
What's up? What's going on?
One of the subjects is detained in a perimeter, which is a four coordinate box around a block. And we're going now because a possible just jumped into a vehicle, so I'm going to see if I can ID him right now.
Sounds good.
Blue shorts.
Mm.
No.
No.
Here you go.
K9 has arrived. What's up, Jesse? He's back on the vlog. Last time we saw him, he was dancing.
Back now, we're trying to catch him back.
Okay, no more training. Now we're real life.
Alright guys, I'm gonna go assist in a search. We're gonna go GoPro mode. So Sarge,
yes,
get you in focus there. You definitely lived up to your word there.
Always, when I'm with you, of course.
Busy night?
Busy.
Yes, I guess you showed them a little bit about police work in Allapattah.
Yes, and it was fun.
So can you debrief a little bit?
Well, we got Nick to run today. He lost some weight. We had two scooters.
Okay.
Possibly stolen. Our auto theft is gonna look into them more.
All right.
Regarding the theft. We set the perimeter up and we had one subject in custody.
Awesome. And normally we like to let the people that are on the vlog, appearing on the vlog, end the vlog in a bang. You got anything for me?
Of course I have something for you, Nick.
You got something for me?
Of course I have something for you.
Let me see what you got.
All right,
Sarge's getting her grand finale underway, and I'm gonna take the time to debrief you guys on what happened. As you saw, I was helping out with the perimeter. We got a couple calls that the subject was in yards trying to gain entry to people's houses, trying to evade capture, you know, by all means necessary. He went up on top of a roof. I saw him, I located him up there. I couldn't really see what he was doing. I couldn't see his hands. He kind of was making some movements, you know, ordered him to come down. He came down and he was arrested. The, you know, Sergeant Diaz, she was able to identify the guy as one of the drivers of the scooters and as the one that was running away from her. So she ID'd him right away and he was taken into custody. So that's pretty much how it goes. We're gonna head inside now and meet up with the crew and see what Sergeant Diaz has for us. So Sarge, you ready? Are you ready for the end of the vlog?
Of course.
Is there a special somebody in here, maybe?
A special somebody?
That's gonna...
Oh, I think it's a little bit.
Oh!
I'm a special somebody.
What do you got? What do you got for us, man?
Hey, rep for Allapattah, don't you let us down.
Baby, I just don't get it. Do you enjoy being hurt? I know you smell the perfume, the makeup on your shirt. You don't believe his stories. You know that there are lines, bad as you walk. Stick around, and I just don't know why.
You are snapped through it all. Ready?
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
Woo! All right, I'll give it to him. All right, guys. Adios.